What's up, everybody? It's your girl Tanya Lady T, and this is Lady T Sensations. It's time to get on the flavor train. Tonight I'm gonna have the cauliflower that I'm gonna mash up as imitation mashed potatoes. I'm gonna do some mushrooms and of course onion steak. I'm doing the leftover rice from the other night, so let's do it. 1.5 cup of water. 1/2 cup of chicken broth. 1/2 cup. Rinse and clean it off and remove the pack. Throw that away. Break each floret into smaller pieces. Put on medium-high heat. Cover and let them cook for about 20 minutes. see how they've reduced down in size. This is about 12 minutes of boiling. So in about 8 more minutes, I will reduce. Okay, continue to boil on medium high, like I said, for about 20 minutes. And then, as you can see, most of the water and broth is gone. You know it's time, and you know it's done when almost all the broth is gone. Okay, all the water is just about boiled out. So you cut it on low. Then you get a potato smasher. And you begin to smash. Just as if these were mashed potatoes. Add butter, about 3 tablespoons or to taste. Some salt to taste. Some pepper. And I, of course, like a little onion powder in mine. Continue to smash as normal, like you would homemade potatoes. And that's how you make smashed or mashed cauliflower. Let's get the vegetables going. Tablespoon of butter. Have to cook steaks on high heat. Mm-hmm.
I like my steaks medium well. When you start seeing that blood, and you know it's time to flip. I do about 2.5 minutes per side. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Cut the mighty mo. Look how pretty that meat is. Woo! Yes, sir. Sizzle, baby. Sizzle. Don't burn, but sizzle. All right, y'all, these bad boys are done. Of course, I ain't eating but one. It's time to eat. It's time to yeet. Yes. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your girl, Tanya Lady T, and this is another edition of Lady T Sensation. Are y'all on the train tonight? Are you on the train tonight? I hope y'all. Anyway, your girl is tired. Of course, as y'all can see, I jumped straight out the car, straight in the house, straight to cooking. So anyway, if y'all saw the video in the beginning, it's kind of long. So if y'all need to skip to wherever, I'll put it in the link where to skip to if you want to just know about the chow down. But, you know, of course, I got steak. I got leftover green beans and onions. I got leftover rice. Somebody asked, Tanya, what you do with your leftovers? They get eaten. And this is the mashed cauliflower, mashed potato imitation. Love it, love it. And, of course, some onions and mushrooms. So let's get to it. Lord, I thank you for this food. Let it be nourishment and nutritious to my body. Yes. Now that's gonna make somebody mad, because they're gonna say now somebody, a cow or whoever had to die so you can eat. Yeah, you know, where were you when the earth was created and God created the fowl of the air and the fish of the sea and all other animals on land that we have dominion, man, woman, we have dominion over. Not that serious. It's not that serious. So anyway, yeah, this is steak, and I'm gonna eat it, partake in it. Yeah, got my Diet Coke. I don't know what it is, but it seemed like when I pour a cold soda over ice, it seemed like it loses its strongness, I guess, if I can say it that way. And y'all, if I talk crazy tonight, please forgive me. I'm just tired. But yeah, we about to do it. I hope everybody had a fantastic day today. My day was good, but yeah, it was, challenging, let me say that. And someone also asked me about the Knorr package. I like these happen to be on sale, so I grab them, but I prefer the Lipton brand or Zatarain's. Yes, and this is the cauliflower mashed, and you would do these just like you would do mashed potatoes from scratch. You add salt, pepper to taste, a little butter. Some people even put pet milk or milk into their mashed potatoes, but I just wanted to taste the flavor, the flavor, the flavor, the flavor. Yes. They're so good. With that little onion powder in there. Yes. It's gonna knock on the door. Somebody say knock on the door. And I like my medium well with just a little bit of pink in it. I'm gonna have to start charging y'all. That's good. Nice and tender. Cooked to perfection. My daddy taught me how to cook a steak. Now, some people may not agree with the way I cook my steak, but that's the way I like it. Okay? Anyway. So good and tasty. Y'all, I am so tired. All these flavors together. Dum 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 dum. Hey, dum dum. You can see it. It's electric. Boogie wiggle 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 wiggle. Yes, I'm about to do the electric slide on y'all. I know y'all probably saying, I bet your Lady T stinks. She eat a lot of onions. Because I found that, and my doctor told me this, because I eat a lot of onions, I don't catch colds. Because onions help to, thwart colds. Oh my God, it's so tasty. So thirsty. Thirsty. And I just like my meat, my steak raw. Not raw, but with no, steak sauce. I just like to taste the flavor of the meat. And just like what I did, I put salt, pepper, and onion powder on it. That's it. I need. Anyway, I want to tell y'all something. That's a piece of fat. I know that's good. That's a good part too. Someone had asked me to talk about a Black Friday incident, and since we're in 'tis the season. Oh my God, it's good. Good gracious. Call a magistrate. Call Ghostbusters. Yes, I'm here for it. Someone had asked me to talk about a Black Friday story time. Here it is. Years ago, when my son was about 28, 9, 10, somewhere around in there. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles were really popular. And so it was popular to get the little game, the little figurines. You know, there was Michael, Donatello, Angelo. I know I'm forgetting some of them. So anyway, of course, this was the year all new Mutant Ninja Turtles would come out. And they would have different costumes. You know, the whole, one of them might have a spear. Might have had a big rock. Who knows? Anyway, so Toys R Us, they had a special going on. Well, of course, just like all other stores, they tell you We have this and that and the other while supplies last. See, that's how they get you in the store. But anyway. They were passing out tickets, so again, you got there at a certain time. The first 100 customers got this ticket. So, there was supposed to be assured one of the new figurines. I just couldn't promise you what it was. And I kept trying to think, what was it I was trying to get? But when I was on the way home, I was thinking about it was them daggone Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. So here I am, standing in line. I was one of the ones that got the golden ticket. I've been daggone. A man lifted their child over their head. To reach for the ticket in front of me. Well, while he was, you know, raising his child over my head, I get kicked in the head. Man, what you talking about? I was so mad. And see, back then I won't say. So once I recognized what he was doing, he was cheating. I was so mad, y'all. I got completely out of line. So from that day to this one, I don't do them rush hour Black Friday deals because I don't want to hurt somebody. Let me tell y'all something. When that joker kicked me in my head, that little boy, and I get it, he wasn't doing it intentionally, but the fact that you were trying to cheat, that was intentional. You should have got there, your hind parts there like everybody else did earlier in the day, and be part of the people in the spotlight. You know, you've got the golden ticket like Willy Wonka. So, I don't do Black Fridays too often because of that very incident. Because I'm going to tell you now, when something like that happens to you, let me tell you something. I almost turned into Elmer Fudd. What Elmer Fudd used to do? Kill the rabbit, kill the rabbit, kill the rabbit. Yeah, I was hurt. So, I know that was a small story time, but I don't do it. But you know what? I understand the fun of it. But let me tell y'all something. You see some strange things. When it was holiday shopping, man, you see some strange stuff now. People who normally don't come out the woodwork, they come out the woodwork. And some folks, you be like, man, have they ever seen daylight before? And I'm not picking. It's like, they don't come out. But anyway, so yeah. Black Friday, I get it, I understand it. It's fun for some folks, it's a sport. But when I got kicked in the head, and you can't touch somebody else's child. And I think I was more mad because I couldn't cuss. I couldn't kick the child back, because that ain't godly. But honey, let me tell you. Yeah, my foot. Yeah, my foot, y'all. I was looking for shotguns and grenades and everything else. I was so mad. Oh, that was so good, y'all. I was watching. I love me some Judge Judy. Not just because, well, I just love me some Judge Judy because you can learn stuff watching her show. You can learn from other people's mistakes. Let me tell y'all something. This one's joking. Cat Daddy, Mac Daddy, Miggly, Miggity, 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 Whack Daddy. Ooh, the overflow. He was driving a car. Long story short, he runs into this woman who happens to be an Uber driver, so she uses her vehicle to make a living. Well, he hit her, and so he was able to talk her into not calling police. Mistake number one. Excuse me. He talked her into not calling the police because he said, well, you know, I don't have insurance yet. I just bought this car, you know, the day before. And, you know, the night before he had just bought the car. And he still hadn't got it registered or insurance. So, you know, the woman was like, okay. And then he also told her some cockamamie stuff like his school check is coming in and it's going to be for $9,400. And I can pay you back, you know, when my school check comes. So she was just trying to be, okay, I'm going to give the brother a break. I'm going to give him a break. So I believe. When all the dust settled, of course, she wound up having to file on her insurance. Then she had to rent a car. So that was some money. So as he was testifying, she said, well, why don't you have insurance? And why is your car not registered? That's what that joker said. Same thing, told Judge Judy. See, this is what Judge Judy do. She know what a walking liar. That's what she do. She reads body languages. That's what she's been a judge for so many years. He said, oh, I was on my way to do all that. And so the lady busted out and said, well, you told me you was on your way to drop off your child to school. He said, yeah, but I was going to take care of my business then. She said, but you ain't even got no license. He said, oh, I got a permit. So, you bought a car, driving the car, no insurance, no registration, and you want the judge to be sympathetic to you. Now, I'm not saying certain circumstances that happened. But Judge Judy called him out, and of course the woman won her part of the case. But people get in court and lie so bad. Self-preservation. See, when self-preservation kicks in, people will lie. And some people lie so bad, you can tell it in their skin. Their skin turn a different color. They start sweating. Just a bunch of craziness. Y'all. This is the jam zone. My friend is texting me. That's that noise y'all hear. I'll call him later. But yeah, I'm telling y'all, you better get up on some Judge Judy. Once you get past her boldness and her harshness, let me tell you now, you'll learn some stuff. Stuff that seemingly seems logic to you in your mind. Let me tell you, that law will say differently. You think you're going to go to court and beat somebody and you say, oh yeah, you got a good case. And then when you think about it in terms of the law and logic, you be like, okay, now I can see how that didn't go in his or her favor. Case in point. Again, I'm telling y'all, people might look at you like you're crazy. But you better make sure that when somebody, you let somebody drive your car, you better make sure they got not insurance, but make sure they got their driver's license. Because here's the thing. If you let somebody about drive your car and they get into a wreck, even though it's somebody else's fault, some insurance companies won't even cover your damages based on how your policy might be written. Another situation. Hey Beth, can you watch Sally Sue for me? And Johnny, while I go to the grocery store, I got a lot to do. I can get it done quick if I ain't got these two children pulling on my leg. Sure, Betty, I'll keep them. Forgive me, y'all. I just love to do accents. Drop them on by. Okay. You keeping Jimmy and Timmy and Sally. You doing your regular thing. You doing your house cleaning. Stop and watch Lifetime. You might watch Lifetime and be like, man, a wife's nightmare, a daughter's nightmare, a sister's nightmare. That's how the movies are on Lifetime. They come in trios. One might be about the daughter's nightmare. That's the title of the names of the movies. Anyway, so you stop and watch that for a few minutes. You might go down to the laundry room and get a load of clothes to wash. All of a sudden, ka-planka, chicka-plinka, ka-planka, chicka-planka. You run in the next room. The kids are playing Wii, and your friend's son accidentally flings the Wii control out of his hand and breaks your 75-inch flat screen TV. Who did it? You know how kids do. One of them. Well, come to find out, little Jimmy, your good girlfriend's son, confessed, and everybody else untold it on him. So here it is. You wind up in court. Now, if it were me, my child, I would try to maybe pay half the cost. But let me tell you, honey, when some people find out how much them bad boys are, they ain't studying how to help you pay. Good friend or not. Let me tell you something about money. Money will, you'll lose a friend quick over money. Let me tell you. I'm a type of person, this is with family and friends. If I've got it to give to you, I'll give it to you. It'll be a blessing if you return it to me. But I don't look for it back because, see, me and you might decide to go shopping and you still owe me $200 and you out spending and popping fingers and doing all this stuff. And I'm thinking, okay, Where's my $300 or $500 you owe me or whatever the amount is? You out here shopping and buying $30 sunglasses, and I still ain't see my money. See, I can't deal with that kind of stuff. So to keep me from being in that arena, I don't give money to people that I'm gonna be looking for it back. If I got it to give you and be a blessing to you, I'm gonna give it to you and keep on stepping. I ain't gonna look for it. It's all about your integrity and your character, whether or not you bring the money back to me or give it back to me, you know, once I helped you out or whatever. So that's just the way I flow. So now here it is, they in court because they done had a breakdown in terms and conditions. I watched your child, and you mean to tell me you're not gonna help me pay for this TV that your child broke? Well, the woman that was being sued, she didn't have to open up her mouth. Cause guess how it went down. And when you think about it, it's like, oh, okay. But again, now I digress. I am a person that, because you did watch my child, and yeah, they was playing, and he broke your property, then yeah, I will help you pay for that. Now, that's Tanya. But the law, check out what the law says. Y'all ready for this? Cold-blooded. The law said that child was in your care. I don't care if it was at your house, on the moon, in the back seat of the car, in the trampoline, in the pool, in the backyard. The law said you accepted a contract with that woman that you would watch her kids while she's going to the store. So anything that happens on your watch is your responsibility. That's what the law says. Yes, sir, and yes, ma'am. So she does not have to pay you. You can sue her, but by law, I can't make her pay you for that TV because you were supposed to be watching her child. And had you been watching her child, perhaps maybe that wouldn't happen. But the fact that you agreed to watch her child while she was alone, so guess what the law also says? Judge Judy broke it down even further. Judge Judy did she broke it down even further. Judge Judy broke it down and said, also, do it on the flip side. She said, now, while you was doing this and that and the other, like I said, I'm painting a picture for y'all. She stopped, watched Lifetime. She went and folded the clothes. She went and did her hair. She went and used the bat. Okay, while she doing all that, suppose that child found a gun and shot himself, or shot one of your children, or whatever the case may be. This is the kind of stuff, and I'm not trying to be dramatic, this is the kind of stuff that happens. Or she, or your child was playing with matches and burnt your house down and got killed. She said, now on the flip side, suppose that woman's child got hurt while in your care, guess what? Your friend would own everything you thought about owning. Because she'd go right after your homeowner's insurance, and you'd be paying her out the yin-yang if that child got hurt while in your care. So I thought to myself, oh my God, I never would have looked at it like that. Because, again, I'm the friend. You're my good, best girlfriend. I'm going to just, hey, I'll pay half. Because, you were supposed to be watching him. Okay? That's Tanya. But the law says, she should have been watching that child, and any type of destruction or whatever that occurs at her house or while you were supposed to be watching her. Because the people, oh, I only looked away. That's all it takes. I only looked away for a second. But honey, let me tell you, that's all it takes. That's all it takes. But anyway, again, those are some of the things I like to watch Judge Judy, because you learn stuff. And especially when it comes to loaning people your car and they get into an accident, or loaning money and not documenting it and you want your money back. I'm telling you, but listen to me. Listen to me. Listen. Y'all seen that YouTube video? Listen, Linda. Listen to me. Listen to me. I'm telling y'all. pay attention to what you do. Because here it is, you trying to help somebody in the long run. They jack you up so bad, not intentionally, but because you just want to wow. But for me, yeah, I'm funny about that kind of stuff. Y'all, I am full. I ain't gonna be able to eat the rest of this stuff. I'm telling you. I'm gonna have to tap out. But y'all, life lessons. I love to learn stuff. People to jack you up. But like I said, I like to be a blessing to people. When I help you, I'm gonna help you. I ain't looking for it back. If I can't help you like that, then I might have to say, well, look, I can't help you like that. But if I can, but I'm gonna tell you, there's some folks still not talking today over $5.72. It's real, y'all. Anyway, I'm about to do it, y'all. I'm about to do it. Sometimes I be talking so much, I don't even know if I be repeating stories or repeating stuff I done already told y'all. If I have, oh well, I'm sorry. So thirsty. I am not wasteful. What I do with this food is I'll wrap it up and cut me a small piece of steak off tomorrow, and I'll have that for lunch tomorrow. I gotta eat one more piece because that flavor just stays in my mouth. Ooh, that's good, y'all. I'm done. Anyway, I cannot believe y'all were at 6,000 subscribers. What? It's all about that flavor, y'all. It's all about that flavor. Y'all ready to tell people to come on over here on the flavor train? All right, y'all, it's over. Thanks for continuing to ride with your girl, Tanya Lady T. Anyway, thank you for your support. I love all y'all. I see all y'all comments. I've been really busy. I haven't been able to respond or comment back on each one of your replies. But, you know, I see it in my feed, and I know y'all are out there talking amongst each other and sending blessings my way, so I just thank y'all so much. I really do. But anyway, I know this is a long video, but anyway, again, get on this flavor train, because what flavor is where it's at. Anyway, y'all have a good night. Everybody sleep well. Bye.